A Chicago skyline, 5 miles south of the one most people know. This is Robert Taylor Holmes, the largest housing project in the world, the poorest urban community in the United
States. Yeah, pour a little liquor for your homies, nigga. This one here brought to my nigga Mike Cruz.
Sitting in the family.
How you come up, man? I started young, kicking dust, man. Living rough, you watch your mouth around my mama, you couldn't cuss, man. I had a down ass homie, though. We ran the streets and on the scene at the age of 14. I packed a 9 and my nigga packed a 45. We're drinking 40s, little shorties, living on the lives. You couldn't stop us, long as I got my Glock, fuck your coppers. Hanging on the block, slanging rocks and making profits. I couldn't fuck with the school life, I was a fool. I played a motherfucker for a tool, man.
What's going on? I hope this this video finds everyone in good health. It's been a minute since I did these Robert Taylor stories. But before I get into what I'm going to talk about now, I want to answer a couple questions. Tonio5100, the only thing I can tell you is the building that this happened, the question you asked, it happened on Federal. The building was on Federal Street. That's the best I can give you. I don't like getting into specifics if I don't have to, especially if something happened to somebody, because, you know, that's just cold. Now let me get to Mimi right quick, because apparently Mimi doesn't get it. Mimi doesn't understand how I do these videos, how I word things, and how I say things. For some reason, Mimi thinks the story I gave on the video she commented on was a fictitious story. But in Mimi's reasoning for saying it was a fictitious story, you have the answers right there. Especially when you commented about DuSable High School. All you have to do is listen to what I said about DuSable High School and connect the dots, read between the lines. Again, I don't say things to give certain things away. These videos are geared towards people who were there. Now, you say you lived in 5100 for 16 years. So if you lived in 5100 for 16 years, and we know 5100 for a good while was a GD building. So you know about the GDs, you should know about the GDs. And if you know about the GDs and you put what I said about DuSable High School together, you should be able to figure this out. I mean, it is what it is. And you ask for the name of the person, saying they're deceased. I still don't give names, even if they're deceased. The question Tonio5100 asked me, I didn't give that person was deceased. I didn't give that real name. So, no, these stories aren't fake. I word things and change things not to give it away, because I want people who were there, who know, to know somebody that was there is still around. But there's nothing fake about what I'm telling you. With that said, Tonio5100, man, that's the best I can give you. The building was on Federal Street. And Mimi, hey, take it for what it is or don't take it at all. Now, wait, let me say this. If you walked around DuSable High School and you were heading, what's that, north up State Street, and you came around DuSable High School and you came down the side back to State Street, what building where would you be at? Put it together. Let us move on. I saw Don Dirt on Vlad TV, and he brought back so many memories when he spoke on things, especially about Mickey Bull. And I will talk about that probably in a later video, I used to go to many parties Mickey Bull's sister threw. And any BDs that are listening, since people want to say these stories ain't real, they know Mickey Bull's sister stayed on 45th Street. She stayed in the building, I believe it was 4500, if I'm not mistaken. And she used to throw parties, man. And we used to go to them parties, man. That's why I selected the song I did, because I started remembering those parties. I want to give a shout out to Mickey Bull. May he rest in peace, rest in power. And I want to give a shout out to Don Dirt for doing the interview. And I know there were things he wanted to say but couldn't say. But I'm going to give a shout out to him. Now, let me get into some Robert Taylor stuff real quick. And I'm going to get kind of personal. So if anybody listening was around during this era, I'm going to give clues onto who I am. Now, we going to get real with this right here, right now. And I'm finna lay some things out. And if anybody picks up on it and catches it and can figure out what I'm talking about, yeah, BD, I'm still alive. I'm still alive, man. Don Dirk spoke on the wars that kicked off after Mickey Bull got killed. He was correct saying the war that kicked off right after Mickey Bull got killed didn't last long. But as I said, wars started kicking off and ending, kicking off and ending. Like, one particular war that kicked off was a long, you know, it was a long war. And I want to speak on the GDs, because the GDs, man, back then, the GDs were very powerful. They're not as powerful as they were back then. And I want to say something. And this might let some people know who I am. Hopefully, the right people will hear this and they will know I'm still out here, man. I'm still out here. It was wartime. We were warring with the GDs. This particular war, the GDs flex muscle. I mean, these GDs, don't mistake them. They were a force to be reckoned with. I can remember one day, during this particular war, right? Now, I have to, like I said, be careful what I say. The GDs had pushed, and there were, at this particular time, there were a lot of BDs flipping GD. When I say flipping, meaning turning. So it was a lot of BDs flipping GD. And for some reason, people thought it was, some of the BDs thought it was wise to keep all our guns in one apartment, in an abandoned apartment, which was not wise at all. So there was a BD that flipped GD. And when he flipped, he told the GDs where we kept our guns at. GDs called the police. Yeah, they called the police, and the police raided the apartment and took all the guns. So at this particular time, the GDs knew we didn't have any guns on that end at the time. So they pushed to take buildings. This is when they took 4946, and yeah, they were pushing. They were pushing heavy. That same BD that flipped GD that told, now, I'm going to see who knows and who was around. That same guy got shot in the face, got one of his eyes put out. After that, he walked around wearing a patch. I'm not going to say the person's name. I'm going to give it an issue. S. That's all I will say. So if you were there and you know, then you know. He used to walk around one of them Slick Rick eye patches. Y'all remember Slick Rick? He used to walk around with an eye patch. I remember one day during this war, we had like two buildings left on 48th. One of the buildings was being contested, but one building was strongly in our grasp. The other building that was on 48th, they were stones, but they had flipped GD. At this particular time, they had not too long ago flipped GD. So they were GDs. Now, I remember waking up, right? And I came outside and I looked, came out on the porch and I looked. Man, the GDs had pushed down on 48. And I kid you not, they was about 500 deep. A lot of BDs, I'm about to tell some truth here. A lot of BDs had left that end. And I will go into this story a little bit more. And this is going to be a story a lot of BDs might not want to hear, but the truth is the truth. A lot of BDs had left that end once the guns got knocked off. So anyway, I come out and I look, and it's about 500 GDs out there in the courtyard. And they were all over. They were trying to push on the last building. Like the one of the buildings we had was being contested because they were going up in that building. But I'm going to say this building, 4848, there was no contesting that. So they were trying to push on 4848. So I come out and I look and I see all these GDs and I'm like, damn, like what the fuck? So it was maybe 14 BDs in the building at the time. And we were going to go out and march out there and fight. It is what it is. I know that sounds crazy, but we was BDs. We called that 49th Gladiator School. We didn't care what end the GDs called it. We called it 49th Gladiator School. We was used to being outnumbered. You know, it is what it is. Let me tell you what happened. The police, as y'all know, I've told y'all, there were police stations in some of these buildings. So the police came out of the station in one of the buildings to disperse the crowd. Man, I watched those GDs whoop those police ass. No lie. One of them, I seen them put him in the Ford Nelson while punching him in the face, and they took his gun belt right off of him. No lie, they whooped the police ass. We're standing up on the porch watching it, and we're deciding what we're going to do, how we're going to come out the building, whether we should go out the back of the building or come out the front. And before we could figure out which way we were going to come out, one of the BDs ran out of the building through the front, and we saw it, ran into the crowd of GDs swinging. Now, why folks did this, I do not know. We didn't even know folks was in the building. He just came out while we're on the porch. I believe we were on the 9th floor, something like that. And while we're talking, looking down at the crowd and looking at them whoop the police, folks just come shooting up from under the building, running head first into the crowd, start swinging. Man, them GDs was on him like ants on a crumb. So we see this and we like, fuck. We start running towards the stairwell. We run down the stairs. We don't take the elevators. We run down the stairs. Soon as we get down and come out the front of the building, it's police every fucking where. I don't know where all these police came from. They're police everywhere. They like, I don't know, but they tackling motherfuckers, rushing motherfuckers, GDs fighting them, swinging on them. So we come out the building. Now GDs fighting us. So we fighting the GDs and the police fighting the GDs. The police turn around, start fighting us. They fighting the GDs. Man, Joe, that was a crazy motherfucking scene. If any BDs is around that remember that, you remember. More to come.